Today, you will finally see us together in a technical video. How so? Because we have found an operator. Today, we'll talk about electronic ignition systems and, in particular, the importance of having a variable timing. High when the engine speed is low, and then gradually lower when the speed rises. We'll discuss today the original Piaggio electronic system, integrated by the KYtronic module, which already has 16 preset delay curves, in order to choose the one best suited to the engine you have on your Vespa. We have chosen to show you this accessory, because it is relatively inexpensive. It's a relatively inexpensive way to optimize the original system and adapt it to tuned engines with a great possibility of making it compatible with the needs of each engine. Although this must be said, the power of the spark is a bit lower than that of some complete ignitions, such as the Pinasco, the Parmakit, Vespatronic and the like. In order not to mistake the KYtronic curves, we also printed them. They are 16 divided into 3 steps. 6 degrees delay, 8 degrees and 12 degrees delay. As we speak, at some point you will stop seeing us, perhaps now, and I will show the curves so that you can see them. So, why is it important to reduce the timing as the engine RPM increases? Because the turbulence that is generated inside the engine widely compensates for the ignition time of the change. Before getting to the heart of the technical matter, let's make a small but very important clarification. The KYtronic module that we have shown is compatible with all Ducati ignitions of this type. Here you see a stator for Vespa PX with its high voltage coil. However, this control unit is compatible with all engines fitted with this combination, therefore Ducati ignition, Vespa small frame, but no, not only. Some motorcycles also have this ignition. There. One clarification. This is the stator of the PX. The part that is interested in the ignition is only constituted by this coil, which contains the power supply and the pickup, and then clearly the external coil. These other four coils concern only the power supply of the electrical system of the lights and have nothing to do with voltage that goes to the spark plug. Pickup is the element that takes the signal from the flywheel, which has two small magnets that correspond to these two sensors of the pickup, and it is an element that often gives problems. Alignment is very important. There is the alignment in the axial direction. Sometimes it seems that the pickup is broken and the Vespa misfires and you can't see why. Instead, it's just that the pickup doesn't align well with the flywheel magnets. So it actually doesn't pick up the signal correctly. Either because the cone is damaged or the crankshaft is defective. These things happen, so keep that in mind. Another necessary clarification. The KYtronic is, this additional control unit delays the ignition timing. Because we're talking about two-stroke engines. In the four-stroke engine, the timing must be advanced as the revs increase. But we've already talked about that. Therefore, the importance of the timing. The charge must be set on fire, having enough time for the maximum burst pressure to be reached a few degrees after the top dead center, about 5. Therefore, depending on the turbulence, depending on the RPM and on the type of engine, you should turn on a little earlier. Early enough. Now, what does the timing give and what does it take away? In general, an engine that needs less advance is better, because it means that the turbulence is excellent and therefore there will be no need to ignite the charge too soon, unnecessarily raising the pressure before reaching the top dead center, which means in a nutshell to remove power from the engine because the piston to go up finds an obstacle. A necessary obstacle to get then the right point and the maximum thrust, but on the advancement of the piston towards the very upper point can also be a problem if incorrect. So identifying myself with the viewer, the advance, in addition to being an hindrance to on the advancement of the piston towards the very upper point, can also be a problem if incorrect. Perhaps a problem of too high temperatures. Of course, by lighting, turning on and igniting first, this fire has time to heat up more. And another clarification. In the two-stroke engine, having insufficient advance, that is, starting too late, never causes damage. The engine heats up less, however, it will be less powerful, it will perform less, it will be less quick at low revs, but it will also have no problems. In the four-stroke engine, on the one hand, the same thing, but on the other hand, the exhaust valves suffer. So this is a very big difference. The four-time gets damaged if the four-stroke gets damaged if it travels too late for that reason. Therefore, having the right advance means adapting the delay curve, therefore in dynamic advance, to the condition that progressively occur inside the combustion chamber cylinder. Therefore, the delay curve will be chosen taking into account the type of engine delivery, but also the individual accessories. For example, the same engine, when the muffler is changed and this muffler has a different tuning regime, it will also be revised under the profile of the selected delay curve. Therefore, the advance curve should not be chosen only for one type of engine, but also on the basis of its overall breathing capacity. Also due to all the accessories. So, when should we start to delay, to retard? Well, when you optimize the parameters that govern the combustion speed, or in a nutshell, when the engine enters torque, you have to start delaying quickly. Why does the motor enter torque though? Because the volumetric parameters are optimized, the engine begins to breathe better, and therefore the turbulence is better, the intake is better, there is no regurgitation, and the conditions for faster combustion are met. If the combustion is faster, we start lighting later to ensure that the pressure peak in the cylinder is always at the desired moment. So we hope that was clear enough. Now, let's get all this stuff out, please. Let's get specific talking about the curves. So, here's the data. Here we see there is actually, they don't because they have the right screen in a second, 6 degrees, 8 degrees, 12 degrees. Which motors do we want to start with and which engines are they suitable for? So let's start and treat practically today only the 4 to 5 curves that affect the engines of the large Vespa, of the PXs with more common preparations, even if they cover almost all of them. Keeping in mind that on the PX on large engines, it is advisable not to reach high rotation speeds, especially with large displacement engines, otherwise the crankcases will be irreversibly damaged. And so here, in particular, we will examine curve 1, curve 2, and curve 7, as regards the curves that delay about 8 degrees. The 1 and the 2 are for engines derived from the original, or little more. The one starts to delay like the two at 3000 RPM, but the one has a slower delay curve, so it stops delaying at 7000, while the curve 2 ends at 6000. So, to give a practical and very useful example, if on the original 200 adequately modified, so perhaps with a BGM shaft with the revised face, as we said in the dedicated video, at about 123, 178 transfer and exhaust, and about 180 degrees of overall intake phase at most, then we could use the curve 1 if we are going to mount a Siprod muffler, but certainly the curve 2 if we choose a Pollini original. As for the curve 7 starts to delay 1000 laps later, then at 4000 and always ends at 7000. And here with this corner we can recover, for example, an original 200 in which we exceed with the exhaust. So the engine will tend to be more empty at the bottom and we will compensate more in advance. If we put the curve 7 with a Pollini pan and an engine with too low an exhaust phase, and we will gull easily. So always starting from the same point, it is clear that if we then put the curve that delays further ahead, but then starting less early, it's clear that perhaps the compromise is reached, but it is a worse compromise, because then where the advance would be needed a lot, instead it's not enough. That's very important. So to make a reference, we could start on these engines that Francesco said, for example, from 25 degrees, more or less 1. 25, which then becomes about 18 degrees, if we are talking about an original 200. If, on the other end, we want to use these same curves for a Malossi Sport, we will start from 23 to get to 15.5 clearly. It's very important, this starting point. We've seen the 8 ones, so we move on to the 12 ones, very important. The most suitable ones in particular are curve 3 and curve 8. Curve 3 starts delaying at 3000 RPM and ends at 6500, while curve 8 starts delaying from 4000 and ends after 7500, almost 8000, but they delay 12 degrees. They are very useful for thermal groups that have large faces, a very high discharge, and therefore the need to operate in very different timing conditions at the extreme performance ranges. Let's put it this way. In particular, to give an example of a heating unit with a difficult character, but satisfying if tamed, is the old Malossi from the 90s, which has very small transfer ports and a very high exhaust. With curve 8 it goes very well because it works very early, up to 4000 RPM, so it feels nothing up to that speed and needs the advance. It begins to enter torque around 5000, the advance is gradually removed, it stretches well and is ideal. While on the other hand, with the other cylinders, for example today's Malossi MHR, curve 8 is fine, with mufflers that make it spin a little higher. But if you choose to make a high torque engine, that is maybe an MHR running 60 or 62 with BGM muffler, big box, Pollini pan, better the BGM big box, it will be much better to choose curve 3, because otherwise the engine would work too early, around 4-5000 RPM and even up to 6000. Let me add a small note. Many people complain about the old 16-17 degrees the old Malossi for this very reason, because they saw it clearly going to fix advance, which was so soft at the bottom, so bad to drive, and then it wasn't appreciated. But this was also one of the reasons, perhaps the main one. Some people, including me, like others, when I was 27 or 28, I took it off because I wasn't able to make it work, but there was no KYtronic. If you liked this video, leave a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Remember, White Run Racing is not a workshop, but an amateur sport association that works on engines only for sport purposes and only for its associates.